We're asked to divide, and we'll find this quotient using long division. A fraction bar means division, so this is equal to the quantity x cubed minus 3x plus 5 divided by the quantity x plus 2. Now both the dividend and divisor need to be in descending order, which they are, but notice how the degree of the dividend is 3, but it does not have an x squared term. It needs an x squared term in long division, so we'll include a 0x squared term when writing this in long division form. So we'll have x cubed plus 0x squared minus 3x plus 5 divided by the quantity x plus 2. So if we have any missing terms, we do need 0 terms in order for like terms to line up vertically. And now to begin dividing, we only focus on the first term of the dividend and the first term of the divisor. And there are two approaches. One approach is to ask what times x is equal to x cubed. If we recognize that would be x squared, we know the first term of the quotient is x squared. If we don't recognize this, we can always take x cubed and divide by x, which does give us x squared, the first term in the quotient. Now that we know x squared is the first term in the quotient, we now multiply x squared and the divisor. So x squared times x is equal to x cubed. And then we have x squared times 2, which is 2x squared, so we have plus 2x squared. Just like when performing long division, we now subtract. Instead of subtracting this binomial though, we add the opposite, which means we can change the minus to plus as long as we change the sign of the terms inside the parentheses. So this would be negative x cubed and minus 2x squared, or plus negative 2x squared. And now we add vertically. Well, x cubed plus negative x cubed is 0, and then we have 0x squared plus negative 2x squared, which is negative 2x squared. And now we bring down the next term and repeat. So now we only focus on negative 2x squared and the x in the divisor. Again, there are two approaches. We can ask what times x is equal to negative 2x squared. If we recognize that would be negative 2x, then the next term in the quotient is negative 2x or minus 2x. If we don't recognize this, we can always take negative 2x squared and divide by x, which does give us negative 2x. And now we find the product of negative 2x in the divisor. Negative 2x times x equals negative 2x squared, and negative 2x times 2 is equal to negative 4x or minus 4x. And now we subtract, but instead we add the opposite. So we change the sign, and change the sign, and now we add vertically. Negative 2x squared plus 2x squared is 0. Negative 3x plus positive 4x is equal to positive 1x, or just x. Bring down the last term and repeat the process one more time. So now we focus only on this x and the x of the divisor. Using the two approaches, we can ask what times x is equal to x? Well, that would be 1. So the next term in the quotient is 1 or plus 1. Or if we don't recognize this, we can determine the 1 by taking x and dividing by x, which does give us 1. Now we multiply 1 in the divisor. Well, 1 times x plus 2 is just x plus 2. And we subtract. Instead of subtracting, we add the opposite. So change the sign, and change the sign. X plus negative x is 0. 5 plus negative 2 is equal to positive 3. So the remainder is 3. Just like in long division, when we have a remainder, there's more than one way to express the quotient. One way to express the quotient would be to say the quotient is x squared minus 2x plus 1 with the remainder 3, so we just put R3. Another common way, though, is to write the remainder over the divisor. So we could also express the quotient as the quantity x squared minus 2x plus 1. Because the remainder is positive, we'd have plus the remainder of 3 over the divisor of the quantity x plus 2. So this is a common way to express the quotient when we have a remainder, as well as this form. I hope you found this helpful.